Do you know why this room, this studio, was actually painted in dark grey? This wall here, it looks like it's almost black, right? Because on the one hand, it was meant to control the lighting, because if they were of any lighter colours, they would reflect the light off and make it difficult to control the spread of light in the studio. But on the other hand, the reason is that I wanted to put a projector in this room. Now, I used to run a 4K laser short throw projector paired with an ambient light rejection screen. And those screens are expensive. They cost me about $1,000. Now, short throw projectors are great in the sense that it doesn't cast any shadows between you and the image. But the problem was that even after spending $3,000 on a projector, the HDMI ARC port was still lacking. Now, to get any form of sound out of the projector required some HDMI splitter or an AV receiver. The ARC implementation was just piss poor, and there was a long audio lag causing huge lip sync issues when Atmos was playing. And that is only when Atmos is playing. Not to mention that it was actually very difficult and quite impossible to get Atmos out of those projectors' ARC port in the first place. So why black or dark walls for the projector? Won't the black or the dark walls simply absorb all the light and eat up the image? Now, let me show you a projected image on my black wall here. So this looks like a completely black wall here. It is actually a very dark shade of grey. The ceiling lights are on. The studio is actually lit. Most of the lights are actually on. I did not turn on the LED lighting panels, but you can see that my face is pretty well lit. So I'm going to be turning on the projector, and you can see on the black screen behind me, the black wall rather, that the image, the colors are not going to be washed out. And in fact, the black wall is not going to be eating up all the light as you might think it will. So the projector is now on. It is taking a feed from my Apple TV 4K 2022 version, and it will be throwing up the image on the screen anytime right now. There you go. So yeah, you can see. Now I'm going to be turning off the lights. So interestingly, the wall is not eating up all the light and eating up all the color. The light from the projector is actually shining into my eyes right now, so I can't be doing this for a lot longer. I'll see you back with my talking head in just a little bit. So you can see that there is actually a large 100-inch image that's cast from about 8 feet away. So this is the wall, and this is where the projector is sitting. Now the rooms have the curtains drawn. The curtains are behind me. The walls are all dark grey. The image is a 4K 60Hz, 60 frames per second image. The input lag is 60 milliseconds at 4K, and at 1080p, the image can go up to 240 frames per second with an input lag of about 8 milliseconds or so. And at 1080p at 60 frames per second, 60Hz, the image lag actually comes in only at 4 milliseconds. The image is bright and the contrast is actually very high. The colors come out very punchy, and the refresh rate is just simply mind-blowing for a projector. Now, to me, the most important aspect of this is that it comes with a HDMI eARC port capable of accepting Dolby Atmos. So if you're looking for a projector setup, then you are in luck. Today we are going to be talking about the BenQ X3000i gaming projector. So what exactly qualifies a projector as a gaming projector? To be honest with you, I don't actually know. All I know at the moment is that the image that is being cast is huge and is contrasty with great colors, and the HDMI eARC port passes Atmos through to the soundbar without any lag. And the response rate is good enough, it's fast enough for 4K 60 frames per second gaming. Now, all of which this projector is delivering in this room right now. And sure, it has some built-in speakers into the projector, but if you're serious about gaming, you will want immersion into the game world, and that doesn't just come with a large image size, it comes with great audio as well. You won't be happy with the built-in speakers in the projector, which is why all the audio output options are going to be important in the projector that you choose. Now, there are three ways that you can get audio out of the projector, this BenQ X3000i. Minus the built-in speakers, you have three, all right? Which you will see in the audio output menu as Travolo. Travolo is the built-in audio. Now, as I've mentioned, you can get audio out using HDMI eARC port, which is the preferred method as it will support full lossless Dolby Atmos. You can also use optical output, and although there will be surround sound, it will be limited to the older 5.1 output format. Now, the third way, which is the least preferred way, is to use the 3.5mm audio output jack. Now, this will just output simple stereo, but it will be the most compatible with older systems or just simple stereo setups, including powered speakers. There are three HDMI inputs in the system. HDMI 1 and 2 are those that are externally accessible, and HDMI 3 is actually reserved for the Android TV system within the projector itself. You have to buy the dongle and you have to slot it in under a panel in the projector. Now, I have connected a Apple TV 4K 2022 version. It is connected to HDMI 1, and a Sonos Arc is connected to the HDMI 2. Now, HDMI 2 is the eARC port that is capable of passing through full lossless Dolby Atmos to the Sonos Arc soundbar. Now, note the settings that I have to do to enable that. Under the audio tab of the projector setup, make sure that you have audio output set to audio written plus, and the audio output format should be set to raw plus. Your Apple TV 4K should be able to output Atmos to the projector, and it will then route the Dolby Atmos signals to the Sonos Arc. So for today's two-part testing, I will be using this setup with the Apple TV 4K. So if there's a limitation to the setup in terms of audio and picture quality, I'm pretty sure it won't be the Apple TV 4K. And the next setup that I'll be using it for is gaming. So of late, I've been spending some amount of time with the Sony PlayStation 5. The PS5 is capable of 4K 120Hz output. So again, if there's a limitation, it won't be on the PS5 itself. Now, in the first test on the movie playback from the Apple TV 4K, I have set the output to 4K 60 frames per second, and the output is set to HDR, and Atmos is of course enabled. I'm going to be playing back some scenes from the movie Spiderhead. Not my favorite movie, but a movie that I've been watching quite a bit of for testing purposes. Now, this is being captured by a camera, so it's not going to come out across as great as it actually is in real life. Or at least I don't know how to capture it like it is. Now, you will notice some banding, but that's the camera's fault. You won't actually see the banding on the projector image itself. Now, it is caused by the shutter speed setting and the 24 FPS that I'm capturing this video on. The actual image itself is bright, it's contrasty, and the colors are great. Resolution is a true 4K image with 8 million pixels. And while you aren't going to enjoy it in this capture, in person it looks tech sharp, and the image is very stable and rock solid without any signs of flickering. Now, one of the most important aspects of a projector or any TV is the representation of black levels or the dark scenes, right? A good setup will show up the dark areas very well. In this subject skin tones, you will see the smooth gradation and make out details in the darker areas of the scene. Now, the Apple TV has some built-in screensavers, which are really nice and sharp. The colors are punchy, and the important thing to show off here is the clarity, the sharpness, and the contrast. Pay very close attention to the areas where there are high levels of details, including all the contour lines and the buildings in the city area shots. And you can see all those very sharp lines. And because of the high contrast, you can make out the details even better. Now, the areas where they're supposed to be black, they come out as all black, as you can see this space here. And even though the wall itself is black, you will notice that the areas which are supposed to be white are actually coming out as white. So all this is made possible with a strong, very strong, powerful 4 LED light source. This is really one capable projector. Now, in the second test on gaming playback, the output from the PS5 is set to the same HDR output as when I'm using on the LG CX OLED TV. The HDR contrast and brightness is not on the same level as when it's being played on the LG TV, but you will get a bright and contrasty image on the projected image from the BenQ projector using HDR10. Now, if you are looking at the image again, you will see some bendings in the brighter areas on the screen, but like I explained, it's due to the camera capture. Now, during actual gameplay, you'll see a much more fluid image. The output is a solid 4K at 60 frames per second. The video uploaded to YouTube now is at 24 frames per second, so you might see that it's actually a little bit choppy. The actual gameplay has much better fluidity and is able to cast a largely input lag-free image, which is completely in sync with the audio. So, as of 3 years ago, large screen projection which reached this level of performance required a projector that is probably in the range upwards of $3,000. Now, this projector right here, this BenQ X3000i, costs $2,000. And as of 3 years ago, the HDMI ARC port on most projectors won't be suitable for use in a modern soundbar using ARC or EARC port. In most projector setup, you will need an AV receiver which will take the audio output from your source device, in this case the Apple TV, and it will output to your projector a separate video image. Now, picture quality from a projector is definitely not going to be the same level as a TV LED or OLED panel. Now, tech is moving at a very fast pace and this is actually coming out very nice and the contrast is simply unseen before in a projector that costs $2,000 before today. And the colors are great. It doesn't look as washed out as the projectors of the past. But if you're going for size, right, which equals to visual immersion, you can't quite get there without spending a huge obscene amount of money on a TV. Even the largest OLED consumer panels today top out at 97 inch and that costs an arm and a leg and probably your kidneys as well. Now, you've got 8 feet of space, right, which is the space I have between this projector and this wall right here, you will actually get up to 100 inches from this setup. If you've got 12 feet of space, you can actually get up to 150 inches from this projector. Now, the projector is bright enough to perform at that distance and image size and all that for $2,000. Well, it's still not cheap, but if you are looking for a top tier LED OLED panel, then that's only going to get you 65 inches in the form of a LG C2 panel. Now, some adjustments on the projector is meant to help you find a suitable place for installation because it's a long throw projector. You will likely have to mount the projector, you know, on the ceiling. And if you have it mounted from the ceiling, you can invert the image even the projector is mounted upside down. Now, if you place it from a low table or a console like I have, it will cast the image pointing about 20 degrees up from the horizon. You can also tilt the projector using the built-in adjustable feet and it will cast the image down if you are casting it from a higher place so you can walk past without casting the shadow on the image. Now, there is also zoom adjustment, which you can enlarge the image up to 1.3 times, that's 30% larger, so you can get a bigger image from a shorter distance. Now, this will of course make the image a little bit dimmer, so it should not be used as default. Now, there is also a two-dimensional keystone correction, which you can tilt the image to get the vertical and the horizontal line straight, even if you have to put the projector off-center to the left or the right or up or down. Now, there's really nothing like size to immerse you in a movie or a game on a large image size cast from a projector. Now, I know a TV panel will easily outperform a projector, but there's really just no replacement for size. I mean, of course, you can get a 97-inch OLED panel if you have the cash to burn. But then again, you can't get a 150-inch OLED panel, can you? So just to round off the video, remember to use proper HDMI cables and make sure that they are up to scratch. From about a year back, any new HDMI cables that I have to buy, I've been buying from Ugreen. Now, these are very well-made braided cables, nylon braided cables with zinc alloy casings, and they are spec for HDMI 2.1. In fact, for this particular setup that I've tested here today, I connected everything up to the projector using these Ugreen HDMI cables. If you haven't already seen the video on those cables, do check them out right here. Alright, so I am going to finish up my race and I will see you in my next video.